One, and thank you, Lisa. So as Lisa mentioned, I'm going to be presenting Section K, Nutritional Status. I'm a registered nurse and I'm currently a senior associate at Apt Associates. So today I'm going to summarize the changes in the revised assessment data element KO520, Nutritional Approaches, and together we'll apply some of the coding instructions and principles to code a few of the practice scenarios. So although there are other data elements in Section K, our focus for today is only on this one data element, KO520, Nutritional Approaches. So here's a screenshot of the item. As you would have noted in the didactic presentation, the original columns, while not a resident and while a resident, have been moved, and they now are column 2 and 3. The two new columns on this revised data element are column 1, on admission, and column 4, at discharge. For column 1, you'll check all nutritional approaches performed during the first 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. For columns 2 and 3, while not a resident and while a resident, the previous instructions have not changed. Check all nutritional approaches performed prior to admission, entry, or re-entry to the facility and within the 7-day look back period. You leave column 2 blank if the resident was admitted, entered, or re-entered the facility more than 7 days ago. For while a resident, check all nutritional approaches performed after admission, entry, or re-entry to the facility and within the 7-day look back period. So for the new column 4 at discharge, check all nutritional approaches performed within the last 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. Now let's review our first scenario. The resident was admitted to the SNF for rehab following a recent stroke. On day 5, they were placed on a low sodium diet, a therapeutic diet, due to high blood pressure, which was exacerbated following news of a family tragedy. Upon discharge to home on day 13, the dietitian recommended continuing the low sodium diet. On day 7 of this PPS stay, the resident was temporarily placed on a mechanical soft diet due to a singular choking episode. Because the resident had no further choking episodes and requested a regular diet, the mechanical soft diet was discontinued 2 days prior to discharge. The high blood pressure improved with the low sodium diet and was continued throughout the stay, and the low sodium diet was also ordered upon discharge to home. So how would you code KO520 for this resident on admission and while not a resident? Okay, so I see that some people checked C, quite a few D, and some none of the above. So here you can see the answer. The answer is none of the above. Now let's look at the rationale. The resident was placed on a low sodium diet on day 5 after the admission to help manage high blood pressure. The mechanically altered diet began on day 7. So for column 1 on admission, no nutritional approaches were performed during those first 3 days of the PPS stay. Therefore, you would choose none of the above. And for column 2, while not a resident, the resident was on a regular diet when admitted to the facility. Therefore, while not a resident, is also Z, none of the above. So how would you code KO520 for while a resident and at discharge? I'll give you some time to consider this, and then please jot your answer down using the polling here. Okay, so here's how you would code KO520 while a resident and at discharge. Both the mechanically altered diet and the therapeutic diet would be checked. Let's look, take a minute to look at the rationale. So the resident was placed on the low sodium diet and then the mechanically altered diet while a resident. For column three, while a resident, both C, mechanically altered diet, and D, therapeutic diet, would be checked. Since for this assessment period, you would check all nutritional approaches performed after admission, entry, or reentry to the facility and within the 7-day look-back period. The mechanically altered diet was discontinued 2 days prior to discharge. So for column four, at discharge, the resident was still on the mechanically altered diet during those last 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. And as mentioned earlier in the scenario, the low sodium diet continued throughout the stay. So now let's take a look at one more scenario for this item. This resident was admitted to the SNF PPS stay with a feeding tube after a long hospitalization. They had been receiving tube feedings daily while also receiving therapy to improve swallowing and to eventually progress to intake by mouth. The tube feedings were ordered to continue on admission to the SNF. The resident received 2 days of IV medication and fluids in the hospital and arrived with a peripheral line and orders to continue both the IV medication and the fluids for 5 more days. Please note that on reviewing the resident's transfer documentation, there is no supporting documentation indicating a need for additional fluid intake to support the need for hydration. So for this scenario, how would you code KO520 on admission and while not a resident? Okay, it looks like a lot of people checked B, feeding tube, A, parenteral IV feeding, and a few people checked some of the other answers. So now let's look. For this answer, you would check feeding tube for both columns. Let's look at the rationale. So for column one on admission, the orders for this resident were to continue tube feedings when they were admitted to the facility. For column two, while not a resident, during their hospitalization, the resident had been receiving tube feeds daily. One important note is that although the IV medications and fluids were continued on admission, there was no supporting documentation that IV fluids were to support nutrition and hydration. So this would not be coded in KO520. Now let's continue with a bit more on this same resident. Over the 3-week stay, 21 days, the resident slowly progressed on a mechanically altered diet and was placed on a regular diet on day 10. Their oral intake was nutritionally sufficient by the last week of the stay, so a decision was made to stop tube feedings and remove the tube on day 17, 4 days before discharge. Now let's consider how to code KO520 while a resident and at discharge. Okay, so it looks like most people checked feeding tube and quite a few people mechanically altered diet. And some checked none of the above. So here are the answers. You would check feeding tube for while a resident and none of the above for at discharge. And let's look at the rationale for that. So for column three, while a resident, KO520B, feeding tube would be checked because this was not removed until 4 days prior to discharge. And for column four, at discharge, the resident had been on a regular diet since day 10. The feeding tube was removed 4 days prior to discharge, so this would not count toward those nutritional approaches performed within the last 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. So to wrap up this section, here are some key insights to coding KO520 nutritional approaches in section K. There are two new assessment periods added to this data element. Column one on admission is to record all nutritional approaches performed during the first 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. At discharge in column four is to record all nutritional approaches performed within the last 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. And while a resident and while not a resident have been shifted to columns two and three, but the instructions have not changed.
Thank you, Brenda. We have two questions for you. And the first is, for K0520 nutritional approaches, does at discharge column four ask what the diet was on the day of discharge, or is it asking what diet was ordered for the resident to continue on after they are discharged?
That's a great question. Thank you, Lisa. So at discharge, providers are to check all nutritional approaches listed that were performed within the last 3 days of the SNF PPS stay that ends on A2400C, which is the end date for the most recent Medicare stay. Therefore, this column is not meant to collect data for nutritional approaches that may occur after discharge, but really within those last 3 days of the SNF stay.
Great, thanks for clarifying that. And our second question, how do I code K0520 nutritional approaches if a resident's diet changes after admission to a SNF for a PPS stay, but before day three, from a regular diet to a therapeutic diet?
Okay, so for the new column on admission, one would check all nutritional approaches performed during the first 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. Therefore, if after admission, a new order was received and the resident was started on a therapeutic diet in the first 3 days of the SNF PPS stay, the therapeutic diet would be checked in column one.
Great, thank you so much.
It looks like we had a request to show the key insight slide one more time. We have time for that. So again, the major change to this item is that there are two new columns. One is for on admission for those first 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. And the last column, number four, is now for discharge during those last 3 days of the SNF PPS stay. While a resident and while not a resident have been shifted over, but the instructions have not changed. So thank you, Lisa.
Thank you, Brenda.